that. Little Logan should be on his way in. Tell him I checked out the new computer. I'll be back on duty before he leaves. Check it out again with him.
Yes, sir.
I'll be in my quarters if he wants me.
Yes, sir. Oh, sir?
Yes.
A telephone message for you. They want you to call right back. Said it was urgent.
Hello. Yes, I got the message. What do you think I'm calling? Well, where did you get the money? No. Come on.
Yes, sir. General Fogan's office, Amon Sloat. No, sir, General, he just left.
Damn it, I need him. Where'd he sign out to? Conklin, you know where that is?
Yes, sir, it's on the way to the base.
We'll get on over there. I'll pick him up myself, Amon, thank you.
This is the house, General.
You sure this is it? You sure there's not another street by this name?
Oh, no, sir. I lived in Omaha all my life. I know this city like the back of my hand.
Well, don't bother getting out.
Sorry to bother you, Colonel. We have some unexpected VIPs we have to show around.
Yes, sir. I'll be right along.
Why don't you come in, General?
Thank you. I
just take a drop now and then. Boy, he gets a little excited.
I'm ready, sir.
Damn snot nose.
Cited Congressman Raskob, the one who's been nosing around the bases. Washington wants us to put his mind at ease. He's on one of those committees.
Yes, sir.
Gordon Knapp will also be there to look over some of that equipment his company makes. He'll be on our side. Anyone looks cross-eyed at his stuff, he goes up like a rocket.
Yes, sir.
Time was when I'd say he goes up like a balloon. Times change.
Oh, I see. That was so rough. Lost half our group. Regensburg was the first one for us. And before there'd be 17. Only 24.
Good airplane, 24. At least you knew you were flying the airplane, not the other way around, like the beast.
Well, you still have to fly the Vindicator, Greg.
Last of all, Flynn, don't kid yourself about that. The next airplanes, they won't be next.
You'll be too old anyway.
After us, the machines. We're halfway there already.
Massachusetts.
How many crews you have on the 24s? Dudes, titans, all kinds. You can tell them apart. They were people. These kids, you open them up, you find they run on transistors.
Now, they're good kids, I tell you.
Sure, you know they're good at their job, but you don't know them. How can you? Get a different crew every time we go up. That's policy, man. Eliminates the personal factor. Everything's more complicated now. Reaction time's faster. You can't depend on people the same way. Who do you depend on?
All right, John. The sky awaits.
You know something, Billy? I like the personal factor.
Those are Vindicator bombers of the Strategic Air Command on routine patrol. Each one of those planes carries four Bloodhound air-to-air missiles armed with nuclear warheads. Those are for use against attacking enemy fighter planes. In addition, of course, each plane carries two 20-megaton hydrogen bombs designed to detonate over enemy targets. At any given moment, night or day, flights of those airplanes are in the air in case of any surprise attack on our bases. You can see some of the other groups just...
Who controls them?
We do. This is the nerve center, Mr. Raskov. This room. All these machines you see are constantly receiving information from all over the world.
And above it.
Mr. Knapp's company did the electronic work on the Argos satellite. Would you like to see what it's photographing right now? No. The picture you're about to see, Mr. Raskov, is being taken now by a camera 300 miles in the sky, traveling at 20,000 miles an hour.
Can you give us a tighter scale on this, General?
Colonel? Those are the rocket sights from 300 miles up. I'm impressed.
You get a sharper net before long. Be able to see the people, not just the machines. We'll show you the hair on their head, Mr. Raskov.
I suppose they're doing the same to us. Well, you can see for yourself. Then let's take a look at the Russian submarines in the Pacific. There's the western coast of the United States, Hawaiian Islands, and those are Russian subs.
Not close.
Nearest is about 50 miles off San Francisco, I'd say. International waters, nothing we can do except keep an eye on it.
Well, that's too damn close. What's doing there?
Scanning us, the way we do them.
Is it on?
Instruments so good, Mr. Raskov, they can tell the difference between a whale breaking wind and that sub blowing its face.
No argument, General. I've surely got the best of my mind.
We're very proud of what we do here, sir.
You ought to be, Colonel.
Money is well spent, Mr. Raskov.
I don't doubt it for a minute. And you don't have to snow me, General. My committee doesn't deal with appropriations. Only with how the appropriations are spent.
Well, you see it all around you. Pretty impressive, isn't it?
Well, I'll tell you the truth, these machines scare the hell out of me. I don't like the idea that every time I take off my hat, some thing up there knows I'm losing my hair.
I want to be damn sure that thing doesn't get any ideas of its own.
I see what you mean, Mr. Raskov, but that's a chance you take with these systems.
Well, who says we have to take that chance? Who voted who the power to do it this particular way? I'm the only one around here got elected by anybody. Nobody gave me that power.
It's in the nature of technology. Machines are developed to meet situations.
Now they take over. They start creating situations.
Not necessarily.
There's always a chance.
You said so yourself.
Oh, we have checks on everything, Mr. Raskov. Checks and counter-checks.
Now, but who checks the checker? Where's the end of the line, Jim? Who's got the responsibility?
The President.
He can't know everything that's going on. How can he? It's too complicated. If you want to know, that's what really bothers me. The only thing that everyone can agree on is that no one's responsible.
Something wrong, gentlemen?
A UFO sighted near Hudson's Bay, sir.
What you've seen, gentlemen, is an unidentified flying object picked up by our radar.
Until we get positive identification, we regard it as hostile.
What do you do about it?
Well, we've gone to condition blue, which is our lowest form of readiness. At the same time, we've informed those Vindicator bombers that you saw on the air before. They will now start to fly toward their failsafe points.
Failsafe?
Fixed points in the sky on the perimeter of the Soviet Union, which are changed from day to day. Planes will fly to those points and orbit until they get a positive order to go in.
And if they don't get that order?
They return to their normal patrols. In short, Mr. Raskob, we can't go to war except on an express order.
How do they get that order? By radio?
Yes, and through a box we call the failsafe box aboard each plane, which can only be activated at the express order of the president.
Oh, he has to tell them?
Not directly, no. His voice can be imitated, you know. He just gives the order, and the rest is done electronically. No one can interfere with the failsafe box, Mr. Raskob. No one. All those new blips you see are fighter planes going after the unidentified object. General Cashew, tight scale, please.
It's pretty cool about this, General. Does it happen often?
Oh, about six times a month. Probably an airliner, of course.
And if it isn't?
Well, then it's something else. And that means it's at 30,000 feet, going 525 miles an hour on a compass heading of 196.
Is it right for Detroit?
7 minutes, fail safe.
Oh, normal procedure, Mr. Raskob. We start an automatic countdown at this point.
Very unlikely the bombers will even reach their failsafe points. I say it happens about one time in 20. We usually identify the disturbance well before that.
Six minutes to failsafe.